Get your thinking caps on, because I want you to imagine this situation. One day, an alien friend texts you and says he's coming to visit. Then he asks for directions to your house. Would you know how to answer? I mean, I'm sure you know the street, city, and country where you live, but could you go higher? Do you know where the Earth is in the universe? Don't worry, I'll help you out. Earth is the third planet orbiting the stars we call the Sun. The Sun is one of the billions of stars that make up our galaxy, the Milky Way. It's a spiral galaxy, which means we can distinguish two basic areas: the historic quarter, the bulge, where the oldest stars live alongside a gigantic black hole, and the modern part, the disk, filled with lighter elements, the perfect place for new stars to form. This is our neighborhood. Specifically, the Sun lies on one of the spiral arms, called the local arm or Orion arm, or maybe not. Astrophysicists are debating whether the Orion arm is just like the rest or a kind of bridge between the Sagittarius and Perseus arms. Trying to figure out the shape of your galaxy when you only have a side view certainly isn't easy. But let's continue. The Milky Way is one of the three largest galaxies in the local group, a club that also includes Andromeda, the Triangulum Galaxy, and a whole bunch of little galaxies called satellite galaxies, which orbit them. If these guys are small villages, then we live in one of the major cities. And in a few million years, our city will be a metropolis, because the Milky Way and Andromeda are eventually going to merge. But we're not done yet. The local group and many more galaxies lie inside the Virgo supercluster. Although recent research indicates that we're part of an even larger structure called the Mauna Kea supercluster. Superclusters are mass concentrations of galaxies, but all around us, galaxies are organized in other, far bigger ways, forming filaments or walls and vast voids that are all part of one great cosmic web. In any case, what superclusters have in common is that they're gravitationally linked, which means they will merge at some point. In fact, the entire Mauna Kea supercluster is headed toward a place where there are lots of galaxies, called the Great Attractor, a deceptively mysterious name. By this point, you're probably thinking this is an endless task, that we're always going to find we're inside an even larger structure, give it a name, and add another line to our cosmic address. Well, surprise, we won't. Once the galaxies are grouped in this web, the universe looks the same in every direction. On the largest scales, the cosmos has a uniform appearance, and matter looks evenly distributed. In other words, from this perspective, there's no way to statistically distinguish one part of the universe from another, so we can't assign it a physical address. In summary, our address is the Earth, Solar System, Orion Arm, Milky Way, Local Group, Virgo Supercluster, Mauna Kea Supercluster. Zip code? Well, never mind. The thing is that this property, the fact that at a large scale, the universe looks the same everywhere, in other words, it's homogeneous and isotropic, is a blessing for physicists, because there's only one family of theoretical universes that meets these criteria: Friedmann-Lemaître Robertson-Walker universes. But I've already talked about them in another video. And remember, if you want more science, just hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching.